The course card that we will be developing using React and Flux will have this directory structure. First of all, we have our style sheet inside CSS directory. Then all the relevant images will be stored inside the img directory. JS will have actions, components, constants, dispatcher, stores, and utils for utility functions. And then we will have app.js file, and this one is coursedata.js, which is basically having the mockup data for our courses. And this one we have over here as package.json. So this is the directory structure that we will be following. Then we will be making use of npm install to install all of our dependencies. And then we will make use of the npm start command to start a process that watches our project and bundles our source on save. In order to do that, we have the package.json file over here. And as you can see inside this file, we have mentioned all the dependencies that we will be having, like Browserify, Envify, React, Reactify, Watchify. So all those things have been mentioned over here. Then we have also specified the versions that we will be making use of. For Flux, we have 2.0. For React, we have 0.12. For underscore, we have 1.7. So this way, we have defined our package.json. And for the course data, the mockup data that we will be having, we have this file called coursedata.js, and inside this we have defined the courses that we will be showing as items for purchase. So these are the courses, their reviews, ratings, course ID, price, author, their Udemy URLs and all. And these have been defined inside coursedata.js. So this way we have prepared our course data file and package.json. Next we'll be taking a look at the app.js file and different files that will come inside these directories. So stay tuned for the next lecture.